Heart disease is a serious health concern for many Americans, including veterans. On this program, we frequently offer information about new methods used by VA in treating heart problems. But older treatment methods are by no means outdated or ineffective. In the late 1970s, a groundbreaking surgical procedure was developed. The technique, called balloon angioplasty, continues to be an effective alternative to coronary bypass surgery that's less invasive. By the mid-1980s, VA, along with many of the world's top medical centers, used the technique to treat coronary artery disease. And each year, it continues to be performed hundreds of thousands of times in hospitals throughout America. Recently, we visited a cardiac surgeon who's closely associated with the success of this important surgical technique at VA, along with one of his very first patients.
In 1984, at the age of 60, Vito Gasparo suddenly began experiencing shortness of breath.
I was worried, yes, and I figured, let me go check, see what was cooking. I didn't know if it was serious or not.
Vito, a World War II Army veteran, came here to the VA Medical Center in Manhattan.
So they sent me upstairs to the operating room, to the doctors, and they found out I had a blockage.
It turned out that the only thing that was limiting him from living a completely normal life was one blockage in one vessel in an area where you could relatively easily put in a balloon, even a very primitive balloon, inflate it, open it up, and make him feel good again. And that's exactly what we did.
Dr. Steven Sedlis performed that angioplasty as a young surgeon. Today, he is chief of cardiology at the Manhattan VA.
What's cooking?
Not much.
I'm feeling pretty good.
Where Vito Gasparo is still one of his patients.
What was unusual is the fact that after all these years, we've stayed in touch, and that he was actually the very first patient that I ever treated with a balloon angioplasty, which is basically the technique that I've devoted my life to. So for me, it's very, very cool.
Dr. Sedlis says the technique has evolved over the past quarter century to the point where now it's fairly routine.
Used to be that the only way you could do this was with open heart surgery, with bypass surgery, which still is an important way of treating patients. But today, most patients who need to have improved blood supply to the heart don't need to go through an operation, but get treated percutaneously, meaning through the skin, with a little tube passed through a blood vessel, and small balloons are used to open up the narrowings in the blood vessel, and then a little metal mesh called a stent is implanted and keeps the vessel open. In people who are having a heart attack, for example, this is a life-saving treatment, and it's done literally hundreds of thousands of times a year in this country. It's become a routine. It's markedly improved people's lives. It's saved countless hundreds of thousands of lives. It's a great technique.
Just ask Vito, now retired from his job running a newsstand. He's been back for angioplasty twice since his first early experience.
At that time, after they finished the procedure, you were in the hospital 7 days. And then the next time, it was only 3 days. And the last time, they threw me out after 2 days. Not that I minded that they threw me out after 2 days.
Over the past 25 years, VA has been a leader in the treatment of cardiovascular disorders, thanks to the kind of research done by knowledgeable physicians like Dr. Sedlis. If you'd like to learn more about how to maintain a heart-healthy lifestyle or how to cope with effects of cardiovascular disease, go to www.va.gov/cardiology and click on patient information.